As the country prepares to commemorate the International Anti-Corruption Day this Saturday, the Inspector General of Government, Betty Kamias, says that corruption is still high in the government procurement system. According to her, corruption is responsible for the shoddy work by the contractors because most of them receive half pay for the work and the rest of the money is taken by the corrupt government officers.
Corruption is syndicated corruption. It begins from Minister of Finance. We have had confessions, but confessions without evidence is the problem. It begins with Minister of Finance, where officials of Minister of Finance have a take, build a take in the budget. It goes to Parliament, takes are built in the budget.
However, all is not lost. The IGG reveals that they have managed to recover some huge amounts of money from the thieving officers. They have followed up on over 1,500 corruption cases and have successfully recovered 30 billion shillings. Over 100 government officers have been dismissed, while others are still under custody facing the long hand of the law due to corruption.
Ugandans work hard and pay their taxes, and their taxes move from their pockets to the consolidated fund. And from the consolidated fund, the unscrupulous Ugandans, whom we have established are not even many, divert it to their own personal use.
The commemoration of the Anti-Corruption Day aims at strengthening accountability, reducing corruption among civil servants, and as well as rally the public to own the war against corruption. Meanwhile, Kamias has sounded an alarm that her phones have been hacked into by yet-to-be-identified people. The IGG has disclosed that she was forced to open up a case with police after her phones were stolen and the unknown thieves started using them to call people soliciting for money.
They have hacked into my phones. They use both my phones, the Airtel line and the MT line. They call someone using my phone asking for money.
Kamia noted that even the phones of the directors from her office have been hacked into. She has warned the public not to fall prey to the tricks of these goons.
I want to tell the public, when you receive a call from my phone, anybody asking for money, please, first of all, don't give the money, don't deal with them, but find a way of calling us.
But who might be hunting the Inspector General of the Government? Report compiled by Juliet Namwaya for the news.